occasions are all focused and centred around disabled issues. We do that on purpose because there are lots of other opportunities for people. I mean, the elderly group have met, they've had their meeting, and where they would ask questions that impact on them, and other groups similarly have whole meetings. So this is focused on disability. So I'm Sean McGovern. I'm currently the chair of the Lambeth Pan Disability Forum. The Hudson's was actually called by the Pan Disability Forum, and it's supported by Dazzles, the Red Payments Peer Support Group, and Inclusion London. And we have a representative from Louise is here from Dazzle, and Ellen is here from Inclusion London. So I'm here from Pan Disability Forum, as is Barbara, who is our secretary. Thanks for helping to get this set up as well, Barbara. Purpose of the event is for several voters in Lambeth to question the major parties in the forthcoming local elections on how they will treat disabled people once they're in office. So the format of the event is a 4-minute introduction by the panellists, questions from the floor, and we've got 8 or 9 questions. Each candidate will have around 2.5 minutes to respond to the question. They don't have to take that long. I'd like it when asking questions if people refrain from personal issues around personal. We're trying to get questions and answers of how the collective, we as a collective group, will be affected. If we need to speak to people on burning issues to do with PIP or care package, anything like that, we can speak to you afterwards. We can either assist you or send you direct you to where you can get the help. Basically, we can just be polite. People are speaking, not to interrupt people. Everyone's got a voice. Each voice is valid. So now I'll introduce the panel. Over to the right here is Charlie Heston, and Charlie represents the Liberal Democrats. And next to me is Jonathan Bartley, and Jonathan is a joint co-leader of the Green Party, and is obviously representing the Green Party here today. We had invited Tim Briggs, who I received a response from his office to say he would attend. And Jackie Meldrum was in the building earlier. The Labour Party sent Jackie along, so they're welcome. So what I'll do is, I'll open the meeting. I was asked, just to give a flavour for the meeting, to ask the opening question. And the opening question is, how well do you think disabled and elderly people and unpaid carers are served in Lambeth? I will first ask Charlie.
Appalling. In one word, it's appalling. Personally, I'm a disabled person. I'm also an unpaid carer. I have been a young carer in Lambeth since I was a very, very young child, and it's been appalling the whole way through. From being told that we couldn't have care because myself and my 12-year-old sister could manage everything back in the mid-90s, all the way through to being told we couldn't have care and me and my sister would have to give up our jobs when my mum was in hospital. And it's just been consistently atrocious for every single one of the last 30 years that I've been dealing with social services in Lambeth. We have no support, we have nothing from them, and we never have. And every single thing that disabled people in Lambeth have ever gotten has been gotten with blood, sweat and tears. With occupying, I occupied Acre Lane when I was 11 with a load of other people, because in protest at how bad things were. We occupied the Centre for Independent Living in the late 90s when they tried tried to shut when they shut that down. Every single thing we had, landlords tried to take away. Every single thing we've got, we've had to fight to the bone to get and keep.
Thanks, Charlie. Jonathan, can you answer the same question, please?
I'm not sure I can add much to what Charlie said. I am an unpaid carer as well. My son is now just coming up to 16. He's a wheelchair user. My kind of route into politics, well, certainly to the Green Party politics, was very much about fighting for him, and much of what Charlie said resonated. Charlie's been at it a lot longer than I have. But just in terms of local elections, you know, there's only so much you can do as a local councillor. But I started 6 years ago, as my son was using his wheelchair, to realise that just the environment around Lambeth was absolutely dreadful for wheelchair users. So I started to get all the drop curbs put in just around my local area, one by one, photographing them, sending them through to the council, getting them put in. With dealing with social services, we get social worker after social worker after social worker. Every 6 months they seem to change, and we get these periods where you get this intense scrutiny and very invasive. We're on the direct payment scheme, and I have to administer that for my son. And you get Dassel are great, and I know there's people from Dassel here. I'm not having a proper Dassel at all. I'm saying you don't get the support from the council through the social worker. I find myself fighting my social worker, who seems to want to cut down the direct payments package to the point where I had to actually make a complaint, and that social worker was moved on. And then we got huge periods where we had no support, no contact with social services. And social workers just kept changing on a six-month basis. We never didn't even know who our social worker was. So these two extremes. So you don't know really, you're left either fighting your social worker or not getting any support from your social worker. I do blame the council for that, for the very poor management. I know the morale is very, very low. I don't blame the social workers, it's the pressure that's coming from the top. And at a time when, as Charlie's been saying, with the disabled rights movement, nothing about us without us. You know, disabled people have had to fight and fight and fight for these rights over decades. And now for the first time, it seems like those rights are being lost. Actually, we're going backwards, not forwards. And there must be support from a council like Lambeth to advocate on behalf of deaf and disabled people. And that is not happening. There hasn't been the ring fencing of the Independent Living Fund. You know, when the Independent Living Fund was scrapped by the government, it wasn't ring fenced for Lambeth. And so, you know, Inclusion London produced a great report on that and highlighted that Lambeth, like other boroughs, is not doing that. And it's failing in so many ways. You know, with the cuts, the £30 cut to ESA, Employment Support Allowance, again, the council is not stepping in to advocate. And it is, at the end of the day, a question of priorities and a question of values. We know that the council is under huge pressure from central government for cuts. So the question to the council is, what will they prioritise, and indeed, who will they prioritise? I'm afraid it is not, as far as I can see, the deaf and disabled people that are getting the priority. It is deaf and disabled people that are being left by the wayside at the time, and they need support and they need removal of those barriers just to have a level playing field, and it's not happening. So, in answer to your question, it's a terrible failure.
Thanks, Jonathan. Laura, you've got a question?